No one ever will replace the style, the wit, the grace. Australia pays respect to that amazing moon-shaped face. Yes, thank you so much.
Wasn't that a fantastic moment, Arthur Kelly? As John Foreman paying tribute to Bert Newton for his 70th birthday, and John is working on more big projects, and he joins us now. Let's welcome him to Studio 10. John Foreman, everyone! Hi!
Hello there, Jess. How are you?
So good to see you.
This is a first for me. I've never done a walk-in before. Oh, I'm thrilled. That was exciting.
Can you feel the ghosts of Bert while you're here with
us? Oh, yeah. Well, I feel like back in this time slot, I feel like I'm surrounded by old friends. Oh, you know?
Enough of the old. Ever.
Yeah.
We don't use that word old on Studio 10.
I'm talking about, when I say old friends, I mean like the blow-up bed and the juicing machine and the vacuum cleaner. They're my old friends.
Because you had some special times, didn't you?
Oh, it was absolutely fantastic. Like this, you know, live to air and, you know, Bert was, of course, the master of that. It's great that... oh, there we are. Aww. Memories of the good old days.
And you had a great bond, didn't you?
Yeah, look, I loved working with Bert. I learned so much from watching him work every day and the way in which he'd, you know, he'd be able to, like you guys do, you know, he'd go head-to-head with a politician and then he would have a comedian on the show and then he'd do a cooking segment and, you know, that was the joy of live television. I know you experience every day as well where... You know, I mean, I remember once we were talking about advertorials, there was somebody on with a one of those car alarms, you know, and he was showing how terrific this car alarm is, you know, and it was a convertible car. All you have to do, Bert, is stick your hand just in the vicinity of the car, of the convertible, and the alarm will go off. And of course, the alarm didn't go off. And you know, then he was tapping on the car and nothing happened. So it finished up with Bert sitting in the driver's seat of this convertible. I can't hear anything there, Bill. And then he got up out of the car and said, here's Bill Tucky to sing for you, and walked off. I played an arpeggio and this poor guy was left standing there. It was great television. We all laughed and then went to a break. And, you know, that was how Bert coped with anything that went wrong on the set.
Oh, he's just such a legend. I love him. But you two had an amazing... What I always remember is you just had an incredible chemistry together. Bond, and he was almost like a father's son because he picked you out when you were, like, 19 or something.
Look, I was very lucky. I worked with Bert on a live show up in Twin Town Services Club and he'd finished at Channel 7, obviously had the huge career at 9, had a little run at 7... and was in between networks. And it was just a person I'd...
Sorry.
Oh, what have I done?
No, I dropped something.
Oh, OK. What is
nothing.
Oh, OK.
Throw tomatoes now. OK.
I thought I might have been saying something wrong.
Stay out.
No, that's good. Yes. Is there an in-joke here or something?
No, there's not at all.
You're not going to punch me in the face, are you?
I was trying to get roll up the auto cue and was trying to get someone's attention to roll the auto cue.
See, no, I thought I'd said something wrong.
Unfortunately, I didn't get there.
Excellent. No, look, it was just great to watch Bert. And, yes, I loved working with him and just seeing him do his thing every day. I think he's, you know, one of the greatest Australian television talents we have. I wish you were on air actually more often now. Yeah. You know?
But speaking of talent, you are incredible. The impact that you've had on music in this country is something else, and especially nurturing young talent.
Well, look, I was very lucky to have music as a child because I was a shy child. You know, I don't know if you remember at school how you had the sporting teams, and you'd have two captains and they'd pick, and I was always the last child chosen, you know. Oh, look, I know, the sympathy, thank you for that. But on the other hand, you know, the music was something that I loved, and I got to sing in the school choir, and I got to play the piano for the school choir, and those experiences brought me out of my shell. And then there was the school spectacular, of course, that came along for me when I was in year 10.
And what about this great new song you've written?
Well, actually, I can't claim credit for this. This is written by the students. So we discovered there was a report handed down in 2005 that said, you know, there's great things happening in music at schools, but there are also gaps. There are some schools where there is no music education. Sometimes you've got one teacher who's got a choir and an orchestra and a wind band, and other schools where there's nothing and people are not exposed to any music education. So the idea is that today at 12:30 Eastern Summer Time around the country, more than 500,000 students are going to sing the same song at the same time.
Wow.
The song has been written by students, six very talented students, together with myself and the wonderful Marsha Hines.
Oh, wow.
So she's a wonderful mentor for the kids too. So the idea really is to raise the status of music in schools. We're talking about it here today on your great national program. And so it's a celebration at the national level, which we're talking about here. It's this lovely Marsha. Celebration at the local level too. This is the process of recording the song. So the song's written by students and also recorded by very talented students.
They must have been so excited to be in an actual recording studio too, to experience that at that age.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's a fantastic experience for them to go through that business of recording a song, singing the song. And so then today, kids of all ages in all parts of the country. Here in Sydney, I'm going to be at Taronga Zoo, and we've got kids singing it and signing it in Auslan at the zoo and up on the Harbour Bridge as well. And I've been learning, you know, about how Auslan and English are slightly different in the way they're constructed. So, for example, there's a lyric the kids wrote which was, "Listen to what we're saying." And the Auslan translation is, "Look at what we're signing." So they love participating in music making, people who are deaf, and particularly at this school. And they're going to be joining us on the Harbour Bridge and the Opera House, but right around the country, every city, every little town, from the 30-person school to the 2,000-person school, there's hopefully something. There's more than 2,000 schools participating.
Oh, we've seen you on morning TV for such a long time, and you are just as nice in person.
Isn't he? Oh,
you
are just beautiful.
He's a good man.
We're going to have a very special performance of that song, Gold, in just a moment. There are kids standing by, ready to sing. The gorgeous. But first, let's say hi to Jono.
Thank you, Moira. Thank you, Bert. Thank you, John. And very shortly, we will have some music live here on Good Morning Australia.